turns from darkness to light. Anytime temptation comes and someone stands to fight. Anytime somebody kneels to serve and not be served. I know. God is on the move, on the move.
To a walk in the Word. I'm Pastor David Corum. We are glad that you have joined us today. We hope that you are receiving a blessing from these teachings each and every day. We are looking today, continuing through the Gospel of John. We're now in John chapter 12, beginning with verse 30. Well, actually, we're looking at the second half of verse 36 all the way through to the end of the chapter. I like to try to conclude chapters at the end of the week so we can pick up the next Monday with a new chapter. So we're gonna go ahead and go from the beginning of the second half of verse 36 all the way to the end of the chapter, verse 50. We've got a lot of ground to cover, so we're gonna get started right away. But let's begin with a word of prayer. Father, we thank you for the opportunities you give us each day to gather together to study your word. And we pray today that as we hear from your word, that Father, you would speak to our hearts, that you would speak to our lives in such a way that we are moved and motivated to move out and to move forward for your kingdom's sake. Father, we give you thanks for all you do to meet our needs in this world and in this place. And we pray all this now in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Okay, let's get started with this. Remember, yesterday Jesus is speaking. The crowd hears it. He cries out to God and he says, I glorify your name. And there's a loud voice. The people heard it. And then Jesus teaches them. And he talks about himself as the light. And he says, The light is among you. For a little while longer, walk while you have the light, lest darkness overtake you. The one who walks in the darkness does not know where he is going. While you have the light, believe in the light, that you may become sons of light. So he's talking about light and darkness. And then it says, in the second half of that verse, when Jesus had said these things, he departed and hid himself from them. So he has gone away from the crowd. He is now alone. Okay? And now John gives commentary on Jesus' situation. So verse 38 begins the commentary, so that the word spoken by the prophet Isaiah might be fulfilled. I'm sorry, let's go back. I missed 37. Though he had done so many signs before them, they still did not believe in him. Again, this is John's commentary. What signs has he done before them? Well, let's recap. Let's look at these. First of all, way back at the wedding in Cana, he turned the water into wine. That's John chapter 2. In the fourth chapter of John, he healed an official son. So when he turned the water into wine, he is the source of life. When he healed the official son, he is the master over distance. He did that, remember, from a long distance. The man came to him and he said, "My son is sick." And he says, "Go, your son has been made well." So even though he wasn't physically present, he healed the man. That was the second one. Number two, he healed a lame man at the pool of Bethsaida. The man could not make his way into the water when the water stirred. You remember that story from John chapter 5, that Jesus is master over time. And then Jesus' feeding of the 5,000 is the fourth miracle that we see in John chapter 6, that Jesus declares himself that he is the bread of life. And then following that, in John chapter 6, where Jesus walks on the water, and then he calms the storm, that he is a master and ruler over nature itself. And then he healed a blind man who was blind from birth, created a great stir, remember that? That he is the light of the world. Jesus declared himself the light of the world. And most recently we read about him raising Lazarus from the dead, that he has power over death. So those are the signs that he had done in the presence of people, and yet it says they still did not believe in him. So that the word spoken by the prophet Isaiah might be fulfilled. Lord, who has believed what he has heard from us, and to whom has the arm of the Lord been revealed? This is a reference to Isaiah 6:1, where John ties Jesus to God, the God of the Old Testament. So, verse 41, we'll get to that. Therefore, they could not believe. For again, Isaiah said in verse 40, he has blinded their eyes and hardened their hearts, lest they see with their eyes and understand with their heart and turn, and I would heal them. Okay, so the indictment then in verses 37 to 40 is followed by exceptions in 41. Isaiah said these things in 41 because he saw his glory and spoke of him. But look at what comes next. Again, this is John's commentary. This is not Jesus speaking, but this is John's commentary on Jesus in retrospect. He's writing this many years after the ascension of Jesus into heaven. And he says, nevertheless, many, even of the authorities, believed in him. This is interesting. Many of the people who were in authority, those who say outwardly they're against Jesus, many of those in authority believed in him. But look at what it says. But for fear of the Pharisees, they did not confess it, so that they would not be put out of the synagogue. Their faith is so weak and so milquetoast that they refuse to take any position that would threaten their position in the synagogue. I believe that this is a statement about a lot of Christians today. A lot of Christians today, I think, say they believe in Jesus. They confess Jesus. They know that Jesus died for their sins. But every time they have an opportunity to speak about Jesus, they keep their mouth shut. And it tells us why. For they loved the glory that comes from man more than the glory that comes from God. What an indictment. What an indictment. We're so afraid of what people might say or what people might think about us that we refuse to speak the truth in love to those who so desperately need to hear it. It's what was happening then, and sadly, it's still happening today. Even among those who call themselves Christians, there are Christians, and maybe you're one of them, there are Christians out there that have never, ever shared the gospel of Jesus Christ with anyone. What are you waiting for? What are you waiting for? Listen, God has called us to be vocal about what he has done for us, and we need to do that. These people, even the leaders, the religious leaders who started to believe in Jesus, kept it quiet. They were incognito believers because they feared the repercussions that the Pharisees might place upon them. Today we fear what people might say about us, what people might write about us, what people might post on social media about us. It's a sad indictment when Christians are ashamed of the gospel, so much so that they keep their mouth shut when they have opportunities to speak. God help us in this regard. And then verses 44 to the end of the chapter, and Jesus cried out and said, "Whoever believes in me believes not just in me, but in him who sent me. And whoever sees me sees him who sent me. I have come into the world as light." Again, this is that idea of light and darkness. "I have come into the world as light so that whoever believes in me may not remain in darkness." Brothers and sisters, we have a responsibility to shed light in the dark places because sin happens and does its best work in the dark. We need to throw the antiseptic light of the gospel of Jesus Christ on the sins of this world. "If anyone," verse 47, "hears my words and does not keep them, I do not judge them, for I did not come to judge the world, but to save the world." John 3:16. "For God so loved the world that he sent his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him would not perish, but have everlasting life." John 3:17. "For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved." If anyone hears my word and does not keep them, I do not judge him, for I did not come to judge the world, but to save the world. Jesus is saying it here. "The one who rejects me and does not receive my words has a judge." They will be judged. I'm not going to be their judge. "The word that I have spoken will judge them on the last day." In other words, their very actions, their very deeds will judge them. Remember, the default for every human being that is ever born is if we get what we deserve, we're going to die and go to hell. And that's what he's saying. The word is going to condemn you on that last day. 49, "For I have not spoken on my own authority, but the Father who sent me has himself given me a commandment, what to say and what to speak." Everything that Jesus said, everything that Jesus spoke was from God himself. Verse 50, "And I know that his commandment is eternal life." His commandment is eternal life. "What I say, therefore, I say as the Father has told me." Wow, that's powerful. Well, we're going to close there. I know it's a little early in our time, but we've come to the end of that chapter and the end of this session for today. So we're going to go ahead and close. I would remind you that you have an opportunity to support the ministry of Living Waters Community Church. It's not my ministry. It is the ministry of the church. This broadcast, this Bible study every day, is just one part of the many ministries that we offer the community. And so we hope that you'll prayerfully consider what God would have you to do and then to give faithfully so that God's word can be proclaimed. I'm going to be faithful to proclaiming the word of God. How about you? Well, let's close with a word of prayer. Father, I thank you for this day. I thank you for this week and the opportunities we've had to walk through the word. And Father, I pray right now that you would be glorified in all that we say and all that we do. Father, that we might that we might be busy about sharing the good news, shining light into the dark places in the world, sharing the good news of Jesus Christ and what he has done for us on the cross. We give you thanks and praise now for all of this, and we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Well, it's good to see you today. I hope you have a blessed day. I hope you have a great weekend. We would love for you to join us this Sunday. You can find us. We'll be broadcasting live on Facebook. We also have a YouTube channel, Living Waters Community Church. If you'll look that up on YouTube, look for the little circle with a water drop in it, and click on that, and you'll be able to see previous Bible study teachings of a walk in the Word and our live worship. We would love for you to join us in person. We are now returning to in-person worship services. We meet at 285 Hugh Hunter Road in Oak Grove, Kentucky. We would love for you to come and join us, or if you're not able to be there, our meetings are at 9 a.m. on Sunday and at 10:30 a.m. The 10:30 a.m., though, is live stream, so if you can't make it or you're not in the area, you can join us by way of live stream, not only on Facebook, but on YouTube and also on our website at livingwaters-ky.org. I hope that you'll join us and worship with us this Lord's Day. And we'll see you again next Monday in a walk in the Word. Be blessed.